New York City Council Speaker Cory Johnson and Councilmember Costa Costantinidis hosted a town hall at PS 171 in Astoria on Thursday, October 4th, where some 300 constituents from the 22nd District had the opportunity to hear from the two lawmakers about recent budget victories for District 22, which is represented by Councilmember Costantinidis. Among other achievements, the two lawmakers announced that a senior affordable housing development in District 22 was fully funded under the fiscal year 2019 budget. This was the first town hall held by Speaker Johnson since his election as Speaker earlier this year, and Councilmember Costantinidis offered him his heartfelt appreciation for making the 22nd District his first stop. The town hall was also attended by civic leaders and other elected officials, and there were greetings from the president of PS 171, Anna Basho, State Senator Michael Gennaris, Assemblymember Catherine Nolan, and Councilmember Barry Grodenchik. All speakers referred to and praised the many accomplishments of Councilmember Costantinidis since he took office 5 years ago, stressing that through his hard work, innovation, and determination, he has been contributing in improving the lives of his constituents through important legislation and by securing vital funding for a series of community projects. In addressing the town hall, Councilmember Costantinidis stressed that there's still a lot of work ahead of us and vowed to continue working hard for a cleaner environment for health and education, including securing more affordable housing for seniors. Speaker Johnson, he further stressed, has been a true friend and a supporter for the many investments made in District 22.
We can talk about the commitment to resiliency and sustainability here in Western Queens, where I know that the peninsula was one of the few places in our district that was affected by Sandy. We need to fight climate change on the macro level, but at the same time, by fighting climate change, we improve air quality and we make it easier for our kids to breathe. We also lessen the impacts of major storms like Sandy in the future. And this is Corey's leadership. We've been able to bring money for our hospital, Mount Sinai, Queens, and make sure that we have a world-class hospital right here in Astoria so no one feels they have to go anywhere else to get the care that they desperately need. And we are going to have a state-of-the-art stroke center opening at Mount Sinai very soon, and we're excited about that. And you know, whether it's passing legislation to make our power plants burn less toxic fuel, whether it's been fighting to make sure we look at buildings and geothermal technology and solar, where all of these things have been in partnership with the City Council and partnership with Corey. And I'll say, as a friend, as a colleague, he really is my friend. We've worked together when he was health chair, passing legislation to make it easier for organ donation here in New York City. We need that. We need to do better. But he has been a fighter for us.
In his address, Speaker Johnson also referred to his close working relationship with Councilmember Costantinidis, noting that his colleague brings forth funding requests for very innovative and worthy projects, and it's very difficult for him to refuse and allocate the necessary funds.
Besides being a great elected official and public servant, one of the things that I most admire about him is that he is a devoted and loving father to his beautiful son, Nico, who has asthma. And we know, as Costa said, that is a big issue across the city. I think 13% of children under the age of 12 are diagnosed with asthma in our city. And the rates are even higher in this community, in Astoria, because of what is surrounding this neighborhood with the power plants and other issues. And so we in the council have been trying to tackle this issue of environmental justice and of ensuring that children get the resources and support that they need. Who is the person that has sponsored all of those bills? Costa. Who is the person that's been fighting for children across New York City who have asthma? Costa. Who is the person that has been the leader on environmental issues in the entire city council? Costa. So you all are extraordinarily fortunate to have a leader who really gets it, who understands it, and who has done an enormous amount, not just to benefit his own district, which is the most important thing, but he has put forth policies that are gonna help kids and people all across the entire city of New York. He has been innovative in pushing for environmental initiatives that are meaningful, wanting to cut down 80% of greenhouse gas emissions by 2050. I put forward a bill passing that, so our city becomes a city that doesn't contribute to climate change, but actually becomes a worldwide leader in combating climate change. And he is someone who, and I mean this in a loving way, doesn't leave me the hell alone during the budget. It becomes, everything becomes about what am I getting for my community? And I think he said it in his opening, which is in the last 5 years, he has been able to secure $26 million in funding for west of 21st in this district. $26 million in funding. In this past year's budget in June, I was able to help Costa by putting in an additional, it's not my money, it's the city's money, but we get to allocate money, it's taxpayer dollars, putting an additional $3 million for the Astoria Library to finish that project, fully funded at $7 million. Costa secured an enormous amount of money. And I think he is the only councilman that, or a member of the council that came forward in this budget and said, I need $2.5 million for schools. And I said, oh, okay, what do you need the $2.5 million for? I thought he was gonna say, let's build a new library or get smart boards. He said, we need $2.5 million for solar panels on the schools. No other council member has asked for that. And I mean that in a good way because he is innovative, he is thoughtful, and he is smart, doing cutting edge things which other folks haven't thought of. And he is a leader in that way, becoming a leader in the council that other members want to emulate. So I am extraordinarily grateful to be here with him. He is a dear friend. And what I said to him when I was elected speaker is, I want you to know, Costa, that whatever you need, I always have your back, which means that I always have your constituents back and whatever you need from our city and from the city council.
After the remarks, Speaker Johnson and Councilmember Costandinidis opened the floor for questions, and for over 2 hours, they discussed and addressed a series of issues and concerns brought forth as to how they can help making the Astoria neighborhood even better.